Desert springs are truly hotspots of biodiversity, where we find, compared to the rest of the desert, many more species of grasses and trees. So that creates a truly unique ecosystem where other birds and wildlife and plants gravitate towards these areas of standing pools and flowing water.
In the vast expanse of the Mojave Desert, these desert springs are a true oasis. Our program is called the Inventory and Monitoring Program. We're here studying various vital signs, just like the vital signs for our own bodies, whether it's blood pressure or a heartbeat. And so these are kind of the heartbeat of the parks, whether they be animals, plants, water, especially in the Mojave Desert. Those are all things that you really have to pay attention to manage these resources in these parks.
We're monitoring for any kind of change that could happen over time, whether it's an anthropogenic change due to humans. We also monitor for any kind of natural change. We are trying to sample a large area of what we have here and seeing how our plant community might be shifting over time. Maybe some kind of shrub is becoming more abundant than it was before, or maybe some kind of grass has reduced its distribution over time. And we're interested in those changes because since these springs support so much wildlife, any kind of change in that community could really change the greater ecological community of the whole entire Mojave Desert.
Blue Point Spring was actually the location where the relict leopard frog was rediscovered after thought to be extinct for many years.
The relict leopard frog
are very sensitive to their environment. Water quality is very important. Amphibians in general are facing a worldwide crisis. Many species are on the brink of extinction. The vegetation is important as a source of cover for the frogs, but they also need open pools. And so we do some monitoring to make sure that the vegetation hasn't encroached too much. Blue Point Spring and some of the other springs like it here at Lake Mead National Recreation Area provides the necessary habitat to keep these frogs from extinction.
So when we visit a desert spring, we collect data on several different properties. First, if water is present at the spring, we measure how much water there is and if it's flowing. And this is our most important data that we collect because it allows us to know where in each park that water is available to wildlife. This sensor measures water quality, so it measures temperature, pH, dissolved oxygen, and conductivity. We also look for evidence of wildlife use, such as animal tracks. This is Male Spring in Mojave Preserve. It's a typical small desert spring that we see throughout our network. It has a small surface area and it's shallow, but we see evidence that it is used by wildlife and it is important ecologically. Springs in the desert may not look drinkable from a human perspective, but it is actually full of aquatic insects that depend on that water to survive. And so when we see those insects, we know that the water is healthy for other animals in the area, like bighorn sheep.
So we're here at Saratoga Springs in Death Valley National Park, and I'm collecting a benthic macroinvertebrate sample. I just want to lower my net down to the bottom of the spring.
So we're looking for macroinvertebrates, which are bugs that we can see with the naked eye. So beetles and snails and those sort of aquatic organisms. So at different locations throughout the spring, we collect organisms from the bottom of the spring. And we try to get samples from as many places throughout the spring as possible to understand the entire spring ecosystem. And these species can then tell us about the health of the spring.
We are at 49 Palms Oasis on the northern edge of Joshua Tree National Park. This place is special for a variety of reasons. This has been a destination for thousands of years for humans, for wildlife. The information that the Park Service Inventory and Monitoring Program provides Joshua Tree is critical for the caretaking of this special place. The oasis itself, because of the biodiversity, the unique wildlife that depends on this area, it's really critical for us to understand what is the water quality here. What's the health of the vegetation? All those things play into factors that help us make good decisions to provide a place for our visitors to come and enjoy the shade and enjoy the beauty of the place, but also balance that with the wildlife that rely on this unique area. Now more than ever, it is critical for parks as we go into the 21st century to really use science to make decisions. We're not in a position anymore to speculate. We actually need to have the data in hand to really understand what's going on. We have increased visitation, and that can create conflicts between wildlife and visitors. And rather than put our best guess forward, it's great to have actual data in hand to make well-informed decisions and explain that back to the public.
The world is changing, so we need to understand how these changes will affect the landscape. From the cultural history we preserve to the wild habitats like desert springs we protect, the team from inventory and monitoring gives us the critical science so we can move forward with a vision. We cannot be true to our mission to protect and preserve without understanding what is happening.